Hi, and welcome to this video. In this video, we want to see which platform you can use if you're trying to run Kubernetes on your own. So if you're running Kubernetes in a self-managed environment, normally you should use like 2 GB of RAM, 2 virtual CPUs. So in this video, let's see some of the cheap or affordable VPSs that you can use to save costs. If you run Kubernetes on a platform like AWS, it's going to be so much more expensive than running it on a VPS. So one of the first VPSs that you can look at is Contabo. The link for all the VPSs will be in the description. You can look at each of them. So if you come here under Cloud VPS, you're going to see that you have the Cloud VPS, you have the Cloud VDS, and you also have storage. But of course, you're interested in the VPS or the VDSs. VDSs are usually more expensive than VPSs. Of course, you want to start with the VPS if that is what is within your budget. So if you come here under Cloud and you click on VPS, you're going to end up on this page and you can see the different offers that you get. So with Kubernetes, they usually recommend that the lowest server resource should be like 2 virtual CPUs and 2 GB of RAM. So you can see that even the smallest Contabo plan surpasses that. You'll get 4 virtual CPUs and 8 GB of RAM. It's important to note that these are shared resources, whereby the virtual CPU will be shared with other people on the server, but Kubernetes will still see that your server has enough features for Kubernetes features to be installed and run on that server. Looking at the dashboard for Contabo, so if you come in here, you're going to see your dashboard, and this is a Contabo dashboard. Or you can do different managements here on Contabo. So let's move on to Hetzner. You can install your Kubernetes on Hetzner. This would probably be my first choice. So if you come here under Cloud, the VPS offers that you get on Hetzner are here under Cloud. Just click on Cloud and you're going to see the different offers that they have. So if I click on prices, you'll see that they do have the standard, which are basically shared. So like these other ones, just shared. And also on this end, you can click on VDS to see the prices. They start at 49. On the standard plan, you'd probably start with this. So you can start with this, which has 2 GB and 2 GB of RAM and 2 virtual CPUs. And you can see that is 475 euros. And if you want dedicated resources where there won't be any sharing with your neighbors on the server, you can come here under dedicated and you can see the prices for this start at 23 euros. And you'll get 8 GB of RAM and 2 virtual CPUs. You can select that here. And going back to Contabo, let's look at the VDS as well. So this is just the same as the dedicated resources from this side. So on this side, you'll get dedicated instances whereby you'll have 24 GB of RAM and 3 virtual CPUs, but this will not be shared, okay? It's very important to note that these are not shared, the other ones are shared. So if you're looking for a powerful VPS and you don't want it to be shared, you can start with something from there. And you can see these are really, really tremendous resources that you get here. Definitely value for your money. On this other end, you can compare with that. And now let's go to the dashboard of Hetzner so that you can see what it looks like. On Hetzner, when you log in, you're probably going to end up on a different window than me, but you can come up here and up here, you can go to the different services that are provided by Hetzner. So if you come here, you can see you can switch to robot. Under robot, that's where you're going to get the dedicated servers. So wherever you are on Hetzner, you can always go to the correct resource that you're trying to deploy or use just by clicking on that. So if you want to go back to your VPSs, you can click there. So you can see these are some of the servers you're going to get here, but there's so many more. Click on that, your servers, they will be there. Now let's head back to Cloud. If you want to deploy a server, you need to put it under project. So within that project, you can deploy a new server. So if you just go inside of that project, you can deploy a server. If I click there on add a server, you can add all the different types of servers that we saw. On the front end, you can deploy any of them here. You choose the operating system, and then you can choose the different types of server resources that you want, VPS server resources that you want. If you want shared, of course, you leave it at standard. If you want dedicated, you'll go back to the dedicated side. The good thing with Hetzner is that you can also set up a network. So you can set up a network for your Kubernetes setup. So that would be something you can do here. You can create a new network where you can have all your different servers. Let's move on to another one. And this time around, let's look at OVH and let's see what are some of the offers that OVH can provide. So on this end, I've just landed on the OVH dashboard and you can see what it's like. So when you click on bare metal, it's going to bring you to this page and you can choose the different types of servers you manage. If you need to get an OVH server, you probably should go to the front end. So let's go to the front end to look at the prices. I will come here under bare metal and here under VPS, let's look at all the VPS solutions. Let's go to dollars. I don't want to use this pound. I want to use the US dollars. There we go. So you can see it also depends on where you are. On OVH, you see you can start with $3.50 and you'll get one virtual core. This is probably not enough for the Kubernetes. For the minimal Kubernetes setup, you'll need 2 vCore and 2 GB RAM. With that said, you'll definitely need to start with this. You'll need to start with this at $11.50 because this has only one vCore. You can also look at Namecheap. I think Namecheap has one for $9, about 10. You can get 2 GB RAM and 2 vCore for $9 on Namecheap. But of course, instead of using that, you'd probably rather use this because you get 4 GB here, 2 vCore and 4 GB. And it's about the same price as the one on Namecheap. Okay, so that is if you want to install all the Kubernetes setup on your own. However, if you want to run a Kubernetes engine and you don't want to use AWS because AWS in the end ends up getting very expensive. So what you can use in that case, you'd use something like Vultra. And if you come to Vultra, the good thing with Vultra is that they have a Kubernetes engine that is built inside of their system. So what you do is here under products, if you come here on this end, you'll see Kubernetes and you can add a Kubernetes cluster. And adding a Kubernetes cluster here is very easy. You just give the cluster a name. And then, of course, the version of the Kubernetes that you want to deploy. And then you choose a location for your server. Let's choose Frankfurt. On Vultra, you only pay for the resources that you're using, just the resources. If you come here, you can see that they've chosen for you high performance, but you can choose something else. Maybe you want regular cloud compute. And for regular cloud compute, maybe you want one control plane and 2 worker nodes. You can deploy 3 servers. And that's going to be $30 if you're using the regular. Now you can see for them, their engine, at least I think it supports 1 CPU as well. So maybe that depends on their engine. But if you're installing on your own, the recommended, you start with 2 CPU, 2 GB RAM. And you can also change your server performance. So this is just the server performance. If you know about Vultra, you know the different products that they offer. And you can choose that appropriately right here. If you want high performance servers, you can choose starting from there. So if you also want a direct alternative for Vultra, if you're looking for a managed Kubernetes engine, then you can use Linode. And Linode is also priced the same as Vultra, whereby they only charge you for whatever you're using. You're not charged for the engine. So if you use 2 servers, 3 servers, you'll be charged for the 3 servers only. If you're using the load balancer, you'll also be charged for that based on the monthly pricing. For Linode, you can check on the pricing. So for Linode, you'd have to check the pricing. And if you come here under pricing, you'll just click on pricing list and you're going to see all the different servers that they do provide. And you can see they have dedicated CPU plants that starts at that price. They have shared CPU plants. So you'd probably start with one of these. If you just want to save on costs, probably you're still learning Kubernetes and you need a place to install it, then you can start with that, which has 2 CPUs. Kubernetes is charged based on the resources that you consume. So if you're using any of these other servers, you'll be charged for those servers times the number of servers that you have. All in all, if you're learning Kubernetes and you don't want to use AWS because it might end up getting very expensive using AWS, what you can do, you can use any of these cheap options. Just in brief, I've said you can use Contabo. You can use Contabo. Let's go back to Cloud VPS. So all the links are in the description if you want to use any of this platform and you want to support me, I will greatly appreciate your support. And if you have any questions, feel very free to let me know. Just ask your question in the comment section and I will see how to assist you. We have Contabo, you have Hetzner, and then OVH. So you can use any one of this. So that's it.